What up, mga solid subscribers, no? So ngayon guys, very big shoutout po kay I'm Pop Rice, no? Very big shoutout po kay I'm Pop Rice. Kanya po itong video na papanoorin natin, no? This video's title na Does Beanie's Management Made the Right Decision, no? So sobrang excited na ako panood to, guys, no? Very big shoutout talaga kay I'm Pop Rice, no? Galing niya pag gumagawa ng documentary na yan. Gawa na ng reaction video to, guys. Tignan natin yung mga pwede natin idagdag dito, no? So without further ado, let's all watch this.
Beanie, the nation's girl group, has been the talk of the town since they went viral a few months ago. Their popularity has certainly helped them reach new heights, but it also means that the general public will be watching them closely at all times. It got to the point where the girls received negative feedback simply for wearing face masks and caps at the airport, which the general public perceived as unnecessary, thinking they were trying to imitate popular K-pop stars. However, this is not true, as the girls had been doing this long before they went viral. The girls also face negative treatment for speaking up to defend themselves against bashers, and especially, for standing up for their right to privacy. It's unfortunate that the girls have to speak up to protect themselves from fans or people who don't understand boundaries, which should already be common knowledge. One of the most disturbing incidents that happened recently involved the girls staying at a hotel, when allegedly a fan knocked on their doors to ask for photos. This incident prompted Beanie's Gwen to appeal to the public through her Twitter account. I really hope everyone respects people's privacy. We appreciate your love and support, and we always try to accommodate photo requests. But please, not to the point of knocking on our rooms just for a picture. Beanie Aya also echoed Gwen's sentiments and stressed that their rest is important. This is what I had been talking about before. We genuinely care for and appreciate everyone who support us. However, at the end of the day, tao lang din kami and need din namin ng personal time and space para makapag-recharge. She also added, thank you to all the Blooms who are very respectful with our space and had asked nicely for a photo. This incident happened while they were in Canada for their Biniverse concert tour. But how exactly did the fan know which hotel room Beanie was staying in at that time? Allegedly, a staff member who was part of the concert production leaked the information. In a screenshot shared online, a person allegedly part of the production staff is seen using Beanie's name to invite a fan to have lunch with him and stay at his hotel, where Beanie was also staying at the time. The production team quickly denied these allegations, claiming that the person is not part of their team or staff. The group's management has not yet released a statement regarding the allegations. However, it is hoped that this incident will serve as a lesson to enhance security for the girls.
Dagdag ko lang, guys, no. Beanie is a girl group, no. Syempre, mag-freak kahit sino naman nag-freak out. Kahit ako nga, kahit lalaki ako, guys. Mag-freak out ako, guys, kung halimbawa mang in the middle of the night may kakatok sa pinto ko. Tapos biglang, alam mo yun, walang tigil sa pagkatok, di ba? Kahit sino naman nag-freak out. Lalo, paano pa kung sila, guys, no? Mga babae po ito, guys, no? Kaya sana i-respect natin yung space nila. Even though na ang intention natin, na kunyari, ako yung fan. Kunyari lang, ako yung fan, na baka sabihin nyo, intention ko gawin yun, no? Kunyari, ako yung fan. Kung ang intention ko lang naman is kumakatok, tapos gusto ko lang makapagpa-picture sa kanila, no? Okay, yun. Pero, syempre, yung nasa isip ng Beanie that time, eh, syempre, isa na rin yung pagod sila, gusto nila matulog, okay, isa na yon. Pangalawa, guys, eh syempre, ano, meron pa silang kunyari, performance kinabukasan, kailangan nila ng enough rest, okay. And then yung pangatlo, guys, is, yun nga, no, mag-freaked out po talaga sila ron, guys, no. Kasi syempre, in the middle of the night, may kakatok, no. And at the same time, baka biglang hindi nila alam, pag kumatok ng kumatok, no. And biglang may gawin na kakaiba. Mahirap, mahirap, kaya sana, i-respect natin yung space nila. Kaya anan sila sa kung ano po yung ano na space nila pag halimbawang wala sila sa stage or off-cam sila, no?
Although it is very clear that what happened was inappropriate and that Beanie's privacy was invaded, there are still people who think they are just overreacting. Some have even made comments expressing hope that Beanie's career will fail. The hate towards them is overwhelming. It feels like no matter what statement they make or action they take, some people will still look for flaws and criticize them, which the girls definitely did not deserve. Speaking of management, Star Music has once again disappointed Beanie's fans, which is why the hashtag Bloom Deserves Better has been trending in recent days. This all started when a netizen shared online that almost every Beanie fan cam or previous Kumu Live video uploaded by fans on social media platforms like TikTok or YouTube has been taken down by the management, leading to copyright strikes and the termination of fan-run YouTube channels that were created to support Beanie. Legally, the management has the right to take such actions as they own the copyrights to the videos. However, what disappoints fans is the perception that they are making all Binny content exclusive and inaccessible to the majority of the public. Additionally, as you may all know, Star Music has launched a Binny website where fans need to pay a yearly subscription fee to access some exclusive contents like live streams and early access to Binny events. Blooms are generally willing to spend to show support for Binny, but some are asking for a better balance between paid and free content. As one fan pointed out, while paywalled content is acceptable, there should also be a balance with free and accessible content. What might be lost in potential income from loyal fans could be recovered through free promotions and marketing that attract new fans.
Siyempre, wala tayong magagawa. Pero please, wag natin i-blame lahat yun sa girls, no? Wag natin i-blame sa girls yun, no? Wala silang ano ron. Para sa akin, ha? Hindi na po sakop ng girls yun, yung ganun, like yung marketing strategy or what, and then yung mga payments na ganyan, no? Wala, hindi nila sakop yan, no? Ang kailangan natin dyan, guys, hindi ko naman sinasabi sisihin, no? Pero ang kailangan nating isipin na may dahilan kung ba't nagkakaganyan is yung management mo nila, no? Which is ABS-CBN and Star Magic, guys, no? So, yun po. Ayun po, sila po talaga yung pinaka may dahilan kung ba't ganun, no? May mga ganyan, yung mga marketing strategy nila, no? Like yung website, exclusive mga exclusive membership na mga ganyan. And then yung mga concerts ba nila? Usually mga concerts yata nila, no? May mga ganun. Yung mga nagsasabi rin ng ganun, no? And ayun, basta hindi na po sakop ng Binny yan. Yung management na po talaga nila yan.
Fans are even starting to feel that the management is simply exploiting Binny's popularity for financial gain. One fan commented, "You can't organize events properly, produce high-quality merch, or release content on the website even though people have paid for it. You never listen to fans and overwork the girls. All you seem to do is squeeze money from the Blooms. What happened to having any shame? You're so selfish. You even removed the content that introduced Beanie's personality to the public. It's obvious you're gatekeeping them. If not for this, their content would mostly be paywalled. New Blooms are only able to connect with Binny through Kumu Lives, but you keep removing them. We are hoping that these ongoing issues with management do not negatively impact the support for Binny in the future. Blooms have always been passionate and dedicated to the group, and it would be unfortunate if these management decisions led to a decrease in enthusiasm or support. Binny's talent and hard work deserve to be celebrated and recognized, and it's crucial that their management fosters a positive relationship with the fan base to ensure the group continues to thrive. But it seems the fans' battle to protect Binny from negativity isn't stopping there. As days go by, their fandom feels more and more disappointment. As you may already know, Binny's upcoming 3-day concert, which will take place from November 16th to 18th, has already been reported as sold out in less than 3 hours. Impressive as it may seem, the supposedly great news for the group has drawn mixed reactions from their fans. This occurred after their management announced the addition of a 3rd day to the concert, which was originally scheduled for only 2 days. The decision to add a 3rd day to Binny's Grand Binnyverse concert has sparked a debate among fans, particularly after a video emerged showing the group's members seemingly unhappy about the additional date. The footage captured during a weekend event has stirred up discussions within the fandom. Some Blooms feel that adding another concert might overburden the members who are already scheduled for 2 consecutive performances. In the video, when some fans repeatedly chanted for a day 3, Binny's Sheena was recorded shouting back, "You guys go ahead," which seemed to suggest that they don't want to add another day. However, this might be taken with a grain of salt, as she could have been joking or playfully engaging with the fans. Overall reaction to the request for a day 3 seems to be consistent, which the fans have noticed. A fan wrote a comment, "Isn't it clear from their reaction that..."
Di ko rin masabi, actually. Ewan ko lang, ha? Okay din, may point din yun, no? Hindi ko rin masabi talaga, guys. Pero I think nalaman nila kung paano po talaga kahirap yung last concert nila, guys, no? Yung Binnyverse, no? Kasi 3-day concert po yun, di ba? Sunod-sunod, no? Pwede rin yun, guys, ha? Pwede rin yun na parang nag-act sila na... Minsan nga, di ba, may sinasabi sila, jokes are half-meant, no? Di ba, may ganun, no? Pwede sinabi, parang ganun din, no? Kasi alam na nila yung experience na, like, parang nasa isip nila, mahirap yung gano'n, no? Parang ayoko na ulit maulit, no? Kasi syempre, di ba, nagkasakit, may mga nawalan pa ng boses sa kanila, di ba? Si Gwen yata, if I remember, nawalan ng boses, and then yung mga sumama ng pakaramdam talaga, as in, no? Kasi tandaan nyo, guys, yung mga ganyan, like yung concert tuloy-tuloy, no? Nakapagod po talaga yan, as in, maniwala kayo sa akin, no? I think kung sayaw, yung sayaw nga lang, guys, nakapagod na, eh. Nakapagod na. What more pa po yung sing and dance po siya, nakapagod, no? Kaya hindi ko sila masisi kung talagang parang yung girls is parang hindi na nila kaya pa mag-day 3, no? Pero kung... Ewan ko guys, ha? Baka yun lang naman ang tingin natin. No? Pero baka kaya naman nila. No? Pero for me, parang medyo ano nga talaga yung day 3. No? Mahirap talaga. Pero syempre, kung yung girls is gusto nila, no? So why not, no? Kung sila naman yung willing talaga.
They don't want this? And yet you went ahead with adding a third day? They have no rest and their schedules are already packed. They're humans. Not robots. Let them rest. Please listen to us. We can't bear to see the girls sacrificing their health again for a three-day concert with a 360-degree stage.
Oh, si Gwen nga yun.
Other fans have also accused Binny's management of greed, arguing that the decision to add a third show is driven more by financial motives than by genuine fan interest. The management is clearly putting greed above the girls' well-being by pushing for a day three. This isn't just mismanagement. It's outright exploitation. Some Bloom suggested that a live stream of the concert would be a better alternative than adding an extra day. Some people might...
Pwede, no? Live stream na lang sana, no? Like, kunyari... Pwede naman, pero wag yun to the point na... Pero I think pwede, pero i-cut nila yung presyo onti. No? Kasi syempre, live stream na, hindi na siya yung in-person. No? Pwede naman yun. Pwede rin yung ganun, guys. Live stream na lang na like. Replay, di ba? Pwede yun, pwede yung ganun na. Magandang idea po yun.
View Beanie's fans as overreacting and feel that they should be grateful for the additional chance to see the girls at the concert. However, it's important to also recognize that fans opposing the idea of a third day are genuinely concerned for the girls' well-being, especially in light of the issues and health problems reported during their first three-day Biniverse concert in June, where some members reportedly fell ill and didn't feel well. Other fans think that it was pre-planned. Given that the third day of the concert has already been announced and considering the success of the initial three-day concert, it's reasonable to assume that the possibility of a three-day concert was planned in advance, and it is likely that this was discussed with the girls beforehand and they may have already agreed to it. A fan commented, "For an event of this magnitude, it's impossible that they didn't discuss all possibilities, potential scenarios, and what-ifs during pre-production. I guess at the end of the day, what's clear is that Blooms are genuinely concerned for the girls' well-being, while the addition of the third concert day is Binny's way of accommodating more fans and showing their gratitude for the unwavering support." Speaking of well-being, Binny's management officially released a statement to protect the girls from those who have been spreading deepfake photos and videos of Binny on social media. The management condemned the spread of malicious computer-generated photos and videos of Binny circulating on internet and vowed to take legal action against those responsible for the content. As per their statement, "Our team has already taken action to remove some of these accounts. We are working with the government agencies and authorities to identify the individuals behind these acts."
Ano magiging nyo?
Star Magic added that the safety
bakit.
And well-being of the Binny members is their top priority and they will continue taking measures against exploitation and harassment. For context, Blooms have been making noise on social media by using the keyword "Protect Binny," urging the group's management to take action and ensure the girls' protection. This happened after a Binny fan account revealed that individuals online were sharing deepfake edits of the girls in a Telegram group channel. The fan account also shared screenshots of comments and conversations from these malicious individuals, including one person allegedly asking for a room near Binny member Sheena's condo. The comments are highly disturbing, as they use explicit language to harass the girls online. What's more alarming is that it appears they are stalking one member and seem to know exactly where she is staying. Binny doesn't deserve this kind of treatment. These girls have worked hard to pursue their dreams and bring joy to their fans. It's heartbreaking and infuriating to see them being targeted in such a vile and intrusive way. They should be celebrated for their talent, not harassed or stalked. Their safety and well-being should be a priority, and no one should have to endure such fear and disrespect. Hopefully, the management will continue to pursue legal action against these individuals to ensure that this kind of behavior doesn't happen again in the future.
Yung sa last part ako medyo na iinis. Hindi ko ma-imagine ba't may mga ganong klaseng tao, no? Like, anong magiging nyo, anong makukuha nyo pag gumawa kayo ng mga ganong klase, no? So, wala naman, no? So, alam mo yun, parang, hindi ko alam, pero parang ang pangit na maisipin na nagpapasikat lang kayo, no? Parang ganun. Hindi ko talaga lubos maisip ko talaga, guys, no? Parang, may something sa utak yung mga ganun, gumagawa ng mga ganun, no? As in, no? Nakakalungkot lang. Nakakalungkot, guys, sobra. Nakakalungkot. Bakit may mga ganun, no? Hindi ko maisip. I think, may nagigain ba silang pera doon? May nagigain ba silang fame or what? Na masabi na magaling sila mag-edit, magaling silang gumawa ng ganun, no? Ewan ko, hindi ko malaman, guys, no? Pero hayaan na lang natin. Basta, as long as alam naman natin at ito, ito yung maganda, no, yung sa mga ganitong klaseng like legal matters, no, yung management naman nila is umaaksyon po talaga, guys, no. Ayun po yung, yun po yung magandang side po na ginagawa ng management nila, as in, no? Yun po isa yun sa mga magandang ginagawa na, like, hindi nila pinabayaan in case na may mga ganitong klaseng pangyayari na syempre aalagaan nila yan, protektahan nila ang girls, no, gagawin nila ang lahat para masugpil or masugpil ba tawa na ano, mabitag kung sino man yun, no? Mabitag kung sino man yung gumagawa ng gano, ginagawa na ng paraan nila. So ayun lang, guys, basta ang masasabi ko lang sa inyo, guys, supportahan natin yung Bini. Alam natin mahirap po talaga yung ano, yung biglang pag-angat talaga ng Bini, no, sobrang ano, kahit sila parang na ano eh, nabigla sa biglang pag-angat nila, hindi nila ina-expect, no, pero masanay din sila, guys, masanay din sila, and at the same time, guys, no, samahan natin sila sa paglalayag nila, no, samahan natin sila. So ayun lang, guys, no, kindly leave a like, subscribe, and kindly ring that notification bell na rin, guys, so maraming salamat. So ayun lang, this is me, Point of Ed, signing out. Peace. Let's cheer.